everybody. Welcome back to Kelly Barlow Creations. If you're new to my channel and you're stopping by for the first time, thank you for stopping by. Welcome to my channel. Stick around a while by clicking that red button for more crafting on a budget, more everything on a budget videos to come. And if you click it again when the bell appears, YouTube should notify you every time I upload a new video, depending on the option that you choose in the drop-down menu of the bell. If you're interested in following me on social media, you can find those links in the description box below. What have I got going on for you for today? Today is a bit of a different DIY, and it's one that I thought would be helpful to everybody right about now. Right about now, there's a lot of scare kind of going on in the world about some of the viruses that are going around, and I'm not gonna speak to any in particular because I don't want YouTube to tag my video or to ding me, but those of us who watch the news, you know that there is an outbreak going on right now that started in one country and it's moved its way to another. And here in the US, it is starting to appear here as well. And so is there cause to panic? Absolutely not. But I feel like there are precautions that you can take to help minimize your chances of getting any of these viruses. And one of them being, obviously, you want to keep your hands clean. And there are times where we just can't wash our hands. Say we're walking out of Target and you just touch that pin pad of the card reader that probably a few hundred other people touched, and you don't know if they washed their hands or not. So you're not really anywhere that you can actually wash your hands for 20 seconds in a sink. So it's always good to have some hand sanitizer on hand just to kind of kill the bacteria and the germs that you might have picked up from that pin pad. Well, I know that in my area, hand sanitizer has been scarce. I have looked at Costco, I've looked at Sam's Club. I've been to just about every Walmart in my area. I went to Target, I've been to three Dollar Trees, could not find it. And so Jeff, my husband, I told him on the phone, I said, you know, I'm kind of bothered that I can't get my hands on some hand sanitizer. And he was like, I'm sure you could make it. And I'm thinking, yeah, why didn't I think of that? Like, you are a genius. Why did I not think of making my own hand sanitizer? I totally could. So I looked up a few recipes. I did some researching because I really wanted to come to you and be informed about it, be educated about what I was making and how and why I was making it the way I was making it. And so today, I just wanted to share with you an easy, budget-friendly way that you could make your own hand sanitizer. And these are items that aren't really selling out in the stores right now. I'm sure they're going to after a few of these videos pop up here on YouTube, because, you know, even on the news the other day, the newscaster held up Germs and was like, yeah, hand sanitizer is scarce right now. It's running low in the stores. It's not being shipped out. Yeah, you're right. It's not. And so I feel like if you know how to make your own, you can very easily like put your mind at ease and make yourself some hand sanitizer, something that you can take on the go with you that you can use that's gonna just help cut down on some of the bacteria and germs that you might be picking up from touching a cart if they don't have the wipes or the pin pads or whatever it may be. And so I know that that is definitely a precaution that I am taking. Like I said, I'm not gonna freak out, but I do wanna be able to wash my hands because there are people out there that kind of rub their nose or sneeze in their hand, cough in their hand, and those spores are in their hands. And then they're touching the cart, they're touching the keypad on the card reader, and then we're going right behind them and touching it. And so, although it is super important to keep your hands away from your face and not rub your eyes, your nose, your mouth, your ears, sometimes it's just a habit. And if you have allergies, sometimes it just kind of happens. And I know with our little ones, sometimes they don't always wash their hands immediately after they've touched something, and then they go and eat food. And so that's just another way of contracting some of these viruses, that if you have some hand sanitizer, you can just squirt it on your hand, wipe it off, you know, rub your hands in, and you're good to go. And that really is my intention today, is just to show you how easily you can make your own hand sanitizer. So let's not waste any more time. Let's jump into it and let me show you how you can do this for just a couple of dollars using some items that you can get at Walmart, Target, Walgreens, Rite Aid, any of these local drug stores, items that you can pick up at the Dollar Tree as well. And it's easy peasy and it's gonna make a lot for just a couple of dollars. So let's jump into it. Okay, so to start off, you are going to need some isopropyl rubbing alcohol. You can get this for under a dollar for this, I wanna say 16 ounce bottle. Now this comes in different percentages. And so the lowest percentage that you wanna use for making a hand sanitizer is 70%. Dollar Tree carries 50%, that's not gonna work. According to the CDC, for healthcare settings like hospitals and clinics, optimal alcohol concentration to kill bacteria is between 70 and 95% for the isopropyl alcohol. And so if you find any alcohol in between 70 and 99%, you should be good to go. You're also gonna need some aloe vera gel. You're gonna need an aloe vera gel because alcohol is going to dry out your hands. And so to prevent it from drying out your hands, if you mix it with some aloe vera gel, it's gonna give you a nice, soft, supple finish on your hands. And this is not gonna leave your hands sticky, so don't worry about that. I just happened to be at the 99 cent store and I saw this brand there, so I picked up 3 bottles of this. Dollar Tree has this brand. I was just there picking up the bottles to use to hold the sanitizer in, and so you can find this at the Dollar Tree. Walmart, Target, Walgreens, again, everywhere carries an aloe vera gel because it's really good for like sunburns or cuts and scrapes, and so it's something that is easily accessible and you're only gonna pay a couple dollars for it outside of the 99 cent store or the Dollar Tree. But if you can get it at the Dollar Tree, I most definitely would. So to mix this, we're gonna start off by mixing 1/3 cup of aloe vera gel to 2/3 cups of the alcohol. Now, if you want a thicker consistency hand sanitizer, once you've done that 2/3 of alcohol, you can go ahead and add just a bit more of the aloe vera gel and it will thicken up the consistency just a bit. Once you've got the consistency that you're happy with, I picked up this 3-pack of these travel bottles from the Dollar Tree. These are perfect for this. And I'm just gonna go ahead and fill these up with the hand sanitizer. Now, if you wanna add a scent to this, you very easily can by using an essential oil. This chamomile essential oil is one that I got at Walmart. I think I paid $5 for this bottle. Now, if you're subscribed to Simply Earth, you're gonna dive into your stash of essential oils and you're gonna pick out a couple of your favorites. I love this Love and Lavender, two of my favorite scents. So these are what I'm gonna add to this. If you're interested in learning more about Simply Earth, I'll link a video in the description box below for you. I'm gonna add about 15 drops because I really want this to be scented. Once I've added my drops, I'm gonna put the cap on, I'm gonna give this a good shake, and by shaking it, it's also gonna help incorporate the aloe and the rubbing alcohol a bit better than using the spoon. And so, now I'm on to my second bottle, and for this one, I added the lavender. And again, I'm gonna give this a good shake and you can really see how well it mixed. And for the last bottle, I decided to go with the chamomile from Walmart. And again, just going with 15 drops or more, whatever you'd like. And with this recipe, you're gonna get 3 bottles this size of hand sanitizer, which are perfect. When using it, you just need a couple of drops and a little goes a long way. You're gonna put it on your hand, rub it in. They say it takes about 20 to 30 seconds to kill any viruses and bacteria once you've applied it to your hand. And again, using a lower percentage alcohol, it does kill the germs less. I think using a 70% alcohol, it says that it kills 95% of the germs and viruses. And so the higher you go, the stronger it's gonna be. And I think if you can get your hands on a 98% alcohol, it kills germs, bacteria, viruses up to 99.99% is what I'm reading on the CDC's website. Again, when using this, I am loving the feel of it. My hands feel soft, they don't feel sticky to touch, and they smell amazing. And now I have just disinfected my hands. Tell me that wasn't super quick and super easy. And here I have three really good sized bottles that can go on the go with me. They can go in Allie's backpack, it can go in my purse, it can go in the glove box. And the three of these bottles, like I said, were a dollar at the Dollar Tree. And what's great is that I still have, let me show you, a ton of aloe vera left, and I still have more than half of this bottle of alcohol. And so you're gonna be able to make at least six bottles with one of the rubbing alcohols if you get this size. And you're gonna be able to do that for $3 or $4. And there's still plenty of gel here. So I would pick up a couple bottles of these, pick up a bottle of the aloe vera gel. The aloe vera gel, like I said, you can get it in clear or green. This is unscented. I think it's just green. And so it didn't really smell like anything other than aloe. And so I think that it's a real budget-friendly way to make hand sanitizer, to put your mind at ease and just help put some protection, that barrier in between you and any viruses or bacteria that you might pick up on any of the public items that you might be touching. I am by no means somebody who really freaks out about germs, but I'm not gonna lie. Lately, I've kind of been germophobic. And it's because, you know, a long time ago, when the swine flu was around, Kayla, my middle child, got the swine flu and she got really sick and it was really scary. And so because we went through that ordeal, now that this is here and it's moving its way into the US, you know, it does leave me a little bit uneasy, because if there is something to catch, my Kayla girl is going to catch it. And I've always been one who was able to fight things off pretty easily. I have a strong immune system, but Kayla, she does have a compromised immune system. She's got a compromised, I would say, respiratory system. And so with this being, you know, a respiratory issue, and then it moves down to a lower respiratory issue, it worries me a bit. And so I just really want to make sure that I can take all the precautions within reason to help protect us from getting it. I hope you all found this DIY hand sanitizer informative and helpful. Please make sure to give this video a big thumbs up, and let's get this video to 5,000 likes, because like I always say, each and every one of your thumbs up and those comments that you do leave down below, they really do help my channel to grow, and it helps YouTube to notice me just a bit more.